estimating surface tension. So to estimate surface tension, we have to remember what causes surface tension. So if we imagine a molecule being down in the bulk of a liquid, we know that it experiences IMFs in all dimensions. On the other hand, if we have a molecule at the surface, we know that it has IMFs with other molecules down in the bulk, but it's missing an interaction down there. It's missing an interaction up here, and that's going to cost us energy. So the energy cost to put a molecule on the surface should be related to how strongly bonded that material is to itself. So to simplify things, we'll use a simple cube model. So over surface, and we'll have surface molecules that are stuck at the surface. So imagine some sort of block being up here at the surface. And we have a block down here in the bulk. And so the energy cost, we know that surface tension is going to be the energy cost per molecule all over the area of that molecule. So if we just know what this area is and how much energy it takes to go from down here to up here, we'll have a good estimate for the surface tension. And we'll use a cube because it's easy to see how many nearest neighbors a cube has. So a cube has 6 neighbors. And so we'll make an approximation that has 6 IMFs, one with each of its nearest neighbors. So you can see over here at the surface, we only have 5 neighbors. Okay, so we can see the energy cost per molecule is going to be the total bonding energy of that molecule, and it's going to be 1/6 of that. So an easy way to figure out the total bonding energy per molecule is to look at the enthalpy of vaporization. Because we know that when we vaporize a liquid, all the IMFs are broken. There's essentially none left in the gas phase. So if we take this, which is kilojoules per mole, and divide by Avogadro's number, this is going to give us energy cost not per mole, but per molecule. Now that would be if we broke all the IMFs, we're only going to break 1/6 of them, so we have to divide by 6. Let's call the area occupied by the molecule at the surface A0. It's this area here. So we'll call this A0 over here. So our final equation for surface tension, since it's just the energy cost divided by the area, the energy cost we said was delta H of vaporization divided by 6 times Avogadro's number, and then we divide by the area of our molecule at the surface. Let's do an example applying this to water. Estimate the surface tension of water. Okay, so we know that surface tension should be approximately equal to the heat of vaporization divided by 6 times Avogadro's number divided by A0. So let's figure out what A0 is first, and then we'll just plug it into this expression. So we know that the molar volume of water is equal to the molar mass divided by the density. So we know we have 18 grams per mole divided by 1 gram per mil. So we have 18 mils per 1 mole of water. We could convert that to a molecular level by dividing by the Avogadro's number. So the volume of a single water molecule, get 18 mils per mole. And let's go ahead and just convert that right away to SI units. There's 10 to the 6th mils in 1 meter cubed, divided by Avogadro's number 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd, 1 over moles. So we can cancel our mils here, and we can end up getting our answer in meters cubed. So we're going to have 18 times 10 negative 6 meters cubed for a single for a mole of water molecules. We divide by Avogadro's number to get a single water molecule, and this comes up to 2.99 times 10 to the negative 29 meters cubed. And so that gives us the volume of a single water molecule, and we're modeling this as a cube, so we know that L is just going to be the cube root of volume. So we take the cube root of this, and that's 3.1 times 10 to the negative 10 meters, and of course area of the face of the cube is just equal to the length squared. So this comes out to 9.6 times 10 to the negative 20 meters squared. So we've got our A naught. We've got everything else. Let's just go ahead and plug it in on the next page. All right, so we've got our heat of vaporization, which gives us the overall binding energy of our mole of water. So we'll convert that to joules per mole. We are going to divide by 6 because we're only cutting off one face of the cube, not all 6. We divide by Avogadro's number, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd reciprocal moles, because we want to go from binding energy per mole to binding energy per molecule. And then we divide finally by the area of a single molecule at the surface, which we said was 9.6 times 10 to the negative 20 meters squared. And so, of course, we're going to get a canceling of the per moles, and we're just going to get joules per meter squared, which is our surface tension unit. And this comes up to 0.11 joules per meter squared. Or we could just say that that is 110 millijoules per meter squared, our typical surface tension unit. And so we see this is significantly higher than the actual measured surface tension. We have to remember this is an estimate because we only counted the energy cost. And we know that the surface tension is actually the cost in the Gibbs energy to create a surface. We haven't talked about entropy yet. So in a separate screencast, we'll talk about how to calculate the entropy of forming a surface. It turns out that forming a surface actually results in an increase in entropy. And so that is favorable and somewhat decreases the cost in terms of Gibbs energy of making interface. So this is really the surface enthalpy that we just estimated here, the enthalpy cost of making the surface.